the big direction I was interested in was that round about the time of writing Eleanor Rigby, when I must have been something like, I don't know, 25 or something, I was looking at the age of 30 and thinking, what am I going to be doing then, as we all were? And in my case, you know, it was a sort of young profession, the music thing, pop thing. And I was looking at, having just written Eleanor and worked with George on this kind of classical, quasi-classical thing, backup, instead of electric guitars for the first time in my life, I quite liked it. I liked the tone, I liked the dynamics of classical instruments. They're not all just on one level. There's quite good tonal ranges in them. So I was interested in that, and I did look at the age of 30 thinking, yeah, that's what I could do. I could become more into the sort of serious side of music rather than just pop hit. But that never really happened. I just still was intrigued with pop hit and three-minute folk song.
One, two, three. Ah, look at all the lonely people. Eleanor Rigby picks up the rice in the church where a wedding has been. Lives in a dream, waits at the window, wearing the face that she keeps in a jar by the door. Who is it for? All the lonely people. Where do they all come from? All the lonely people. Where do they all belong?
McCartney's chance to extend his composing skills came here with Eleanor Rigby. Using the same theme, the fantasy was designed to move from the Albert Hall into a Victorian landscape. The rough cut of the final sequence proved to be longer than first envisaged, and in its new length was presented back to McCartney for scoring.
To make things even worse, just for something to edit to, they'd put a Brahms violin concerto on for the track. So it was like, oh God, you know, what have they left us with? 8 minutes here that we didn't know was coming. With a Brahms type mood to it. That was the thing, you know, it was like, well, how to get out of that was the one. And so I took that kind of problem home and then thought, well, you know, if I turn the sound down on the video, and I just tried to write my own kind, sort of classical music, sort of film score, tunes, really. I mean, it's still just tunes, the way I see it. You know, it's still, I mean, classical music is just a lot of tunes or one reoccurring tune or whatever, but it still generally is still what I do. But it's just a different way of doing it. So I approached it from my same old angle, which is to get a tune I like, to voice it the way I like it, to get the dynamics how I like them, to get it to come and go, to reoccur, and to do all the stuff I like to have happen in my music. But the big thing was there were no words to help me out, and to suddenly you couldn't keep bringing back choruses and stuff. It had to fit with the film. And I must say I enjoyed that. Harking back to this, what will I be doing when I was 30? Here I was at 40, being forced into what I thought I might have been doing at 30. So it kind of fitted. I thought, well, yeah, it's probably about time I tried to just do something different for me. So we've ended up, I'm not sure how long it is, I think it's about 9 or 10 minutes, where it just is pure music. It just is a classical orchestra. And they rabbit on for about 9 minutes. But I like the end effect.
Do they all belong?
I mean, we've all been saying, you know, even Mick Jagger, all been saying, well, 50, you can't, he can't leap around like that at 50. I mean, we, come on, Mick, you know, own up. You know, we just can't, love. Anyway, so you've got to be looking at something that's a little bit quieter, and you've got to be looking, in my case, I've always had this thing of composer as well as sort of singer and bass player. And I've always really liked it. It's always been one of my secret little dreams, you know. In a corny way, I've always liked that role of composer. So to see myself actually sitting down at the piano, I was really just checking for boredom and just checking, do I hate this, you know, or am I actually enjoying this? And I found when I got it right, to my satisfaction, I really enjoyed it.
Thank you.